You know, I don't like to do all the introductions. I mean, we've spent a lot of budget this year on getting some special bits made, so I should really use them.
This is Steve Aoki.
No expense spared, my friend. Steve Aoki's in the house.
Yeah, yo, what's up?
Mate, you know what? You are part of this furniture at this place because I think this was the first time we met here, and it was way, 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 way back. And I just reminded you of Dimac had a scooter suitcase.
Yeah, those were amazing, especially for like the, if you want to travel around the airport, you know, this is pre-hovercraft.
Yeah.
Or whatever, hoverboards.
Pre-electric.
But yeah, it's amazing. You just pop them open and, roll around.
I searched for one on eBay just to see if they could get one. It was pricey, I'll tell you that.
I know, yeah.
But are they still on the line? Are they still
No, we did like a run and then, you know, you got to keep moving. You got to keep doing different stuff.
What's the merch? The latest merch, I can see you're wearing some hot Dimac dungarees.
Yeah. All right.
They're not available online, are they?
No, I literally just got them shipped from my team. And it's promoting my new song called Crash.
Yeah. We need to talk about that with Darren Chris,
yeah? Yes, yes, yes. It's happening today. It's happening.
Is it out today?
Well, it's out already. It just came out.
Right.
Darren is going to be joining me on stage.
Wicked.
So this will be the first time that we perform the song, and you know, he's super hyped. I don't know where he is. He's running around Tomorrowland. He's getting all excited.
So this is the guy, Darren Chris, that took a Dave Matthews track and said, hey, Steve, you know what? We should do something, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. We're in the studio. We're trying to figure out what are we going to do together.
Yeah.
He's an incredible singer, and he started playing the Dave Matthews Crash Into Me, and he's like, yo, I really want to do something with this. I'm like, this is the first starting point. You know, let's see what we can do with this record. So we just kind of kept mulling it over and mulling it over. And then I started working on the production and got him in the booth. And right then and there, it just started happening.
Bingo. And now it's out and on stage. I'm really looking forward to seeing that live. You always surprise us, and that's what I love. You've always done that, and I never know what's next with you.
That's another thing that's exciting about this song is that no one would put Steve Aoki and Dave Matthews Band together, let alone Darren Chris.
Never.
So all of these things, it's about like surprising, you know, people with some, you know, unique ways to reinvent songs or bring new songs to life.
Yeah, but if it's not the Playhouse, if it's not the Boot Camp, it's like something else. It's Dimac, and I love your entrepreneurial way. I know that it runs deep in the family, but I love
that.
It. And let's just quickly, I keep hounding you about this book. Your book comes out in September.
Yeah, it's pre-order now. It's available now for pre-order. It's coming out in September. And it took me 5 years to pen and put down. It was difficult. It's difficult because I'm not a writer. I could definitely write, you know, stories down, but took time to get there. And it's, you know, unveiling a lot of, you know, stories I never got to share with people. So
share me the title of the book.
It's called Blue.
Nice.
The Color of Noise.
And it's your favorite color. It's your name as well, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. Aoki. It's Blue Tree.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's my favorite color. It's funny because I didn't even put the two and two together until I was at the end of writing the book that I was like, wait, my last name is Blue Tree.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's you know, coincidences are running a lot in the book.
And the foundation as well. But look, this is part one. We're going to speak part two next week. What I want you to do for me is I want you to finish this sentence. The thing I hear people talk about the most at Tomorrowland is...
is One World Radio.
Right, that's good. That's top journalist. You've got to wake up early to get this guy out. All right, then I'm going to play a game with you because I know you've got to go. We could talk forever, you know that. And I know that we're talking all over Ollie's set, so apologies for that. But I want to play a quick game. You don't know what this is. It's just on the spot right now. We're celebrating being 15.
Okay.
So I'm going to give you 15 seconds. And in those 15 seconds, and I know you DJs are all competitive, there's a leaderboard.
Okay.
I've got Sheck on this leaderboard.
Yeah.
It's as big as he is.
Yeah.
He's on it.
Yeah.
You need to name as many of your own titles of productions or remixes as possible. Are you game for this? Yeah?
I'm trying my best, yeah.
All right, okay, that's the idea. You can only try your best. You've got 15 seconds, celebrating 15 years. Your time starts now. Stevie Aoki, go.
No Beef, Turbulence, Crashing In Me, Just Hold On, Wasted On Me, Mic Drop, Jeez, I can't believe Neon Future, Noble Gas. Wow, it's crazy, right? It's crazy.
There you go.
It's crazy when you're like, okay, I want to roll. Then boom, your brain stops. You're like, I should remember this.
How many tracks do you think you've made in your life just that have been released in the world? Maybe like...
Well, last year, I think there was like 40, over 40.
Yeah.
Because I did a year-end mix. I was like, wow, I did 40 records.
And
like,
you only got 9.
I got 9. Yeah.
No, you did well.
I'm gonna need some luck for my set tonight.
You're gonna play like that many tonight. So you're now the I don't know what the word for five leaders is, but you're joint fifth at the top.
Okay, all right. Okay, all right. Who's number one?
And we got no. You're at the top spot. To be fair, but there's five others with 9. That is Sam Feld, Oliver Heldens, Bart B. Moore, and Julian Jordan. All right, there you go.
Who's no one's beat 9?
No, you've got.
You gotta be kidding.
No, DJ Diesel on 6. You've got Sunway and Ryan on 7. You've got Double Pleasure on 6. All right, there you go.
I wish I got 8. I was. Or, I mean 10. 10. I wish I got 10. If I got 10, I would be.
You on for that.
Oh man, I needed that 10th one.
He goes, nah. I'll tell you what. I'll give you a chance next week.
Please,
to be...
please.
And the winner gets a trophy. All right, I'm gonna let you go. There's so many things I want to speak to you about. I love you. We love you. I know. Our entire audience love you. Thanks for launching us as a station. If you didn't know that, go watch the video. It's on YouTube. Dude, off you go. Enjoy yourselves.
Okay,
and 3 Are Legend, we didn't even talk about that.
Sunday.
Yes. Can we speak Sunday?
Yeah. So, I mean, 3 Are Legend, this set is special for the 15-year anniversary of Tomorrowland.
Yep.
Playing the classics.
I can't wait.
You know, it's not about the new music. It's about the classics that
built Tomorrowland. The Tomorrowland anthems.
Yes. Yes, very much so. So, you know... We're debuting a new song called Khaleesi.
What? In from 26. Game of Thrones?
Yeah, well, that's the name of the song.
Yeah, I know, but still.
With W&W, but it's not even about the new 3 Are Legend. It's about 3 Are Legend representing all the classic records that define Tomorrowland.
And Friends, right?
Yes. Okay, cool. It's a big love affair on stage.
I'm putting a request in now. You, Timmy and Mike in here for just a few minutes on Sunday before you go on stage, right?
Yeah.
I'll put the request in with the press people. I want that to happen. Steve Aoki. We love you.
Thank you.
Go do what you got to do. Right. We're looking forward to it. We can't wait. Steve Aoki on Tomorrowland, One World Radio.